And the United States, a massive operation is underway, and that's to clear the mangled debris of the bridge that collapsed in Baltimore. Teams of engineers have started work on the intricate process of cutting and lifting the first section of the twisted steel crews that are measuring and cutting the steel from the broken bridge before attaching straps so that it can be lifted onto a barge. Maryland's Governor Wes Moore briefed the media on clearing operations and opening up of the shipping channel. Moore laid emphasis on the importance of Baltimore Port for the local economy.
The Army Corps and their partners will begin to move forward with the crane operations today. The north sections of the key bridge are going to be cut up and removed. This will eventually allow us to open up a temporary restricted channel that will help us to get more vessels in the water around the site of the collapse. Our economy depends on the Port of Baltimore, and the Port of Baltimore depends on vessel traffic.
According to Governor Moore, equipment on hand includes 7 floating cranes that have already been moved in. The largest of them can lift a load of 1,000 tons, 10 tugboats, 9 barges, 8 salvage vessels, 5 Coast Guard boats have also been deployed at the site. Baltimore's thrumming port has long been an economic engine that provides thousands of jobs for Maryland residents. The collapse has had an impact on local business and industrial production. For latest news, download the WION app and subscribe to our YouTube channel.